modern technology in agriculture have learned. All this old technology used for this is technology of war. And so we have a dilemma in our agriculture. We have technology, but we have no machinery to do that. We have to construct them. It functions perfectly. This machine has been developed and constructed in order to achieve or create seed beds, planting beds for trees, but also can be used for cultivation of vegetables, of any vegetables. The width, we limited it for 80 centimeters, which is sufficient for a seed bed for trees and also for vegetables. The principle is easy. There are two implements, devices integrated in one another. You have the rotative hole and you have the subsoiler. And the subsoiler, we designed it in a way so that you have the middle one, it's got deeper, and you have the side one a little less deeper. And so you will have a seed bed deeper in the middle and a little bit less deep on the side. This one is adjustable, you can go deeper or less deep. And so passing once upon a pasture land or whatever you have, you will get a perfectly prepared seed bed. And then this part is also adjustable. That's the distance. Can lift or go down it in order to increase or decrease the depth. That's, this will grow, but because we are not necessarily interested to kill earthworms or to mix soil. It's only in order to cut the rootstocks, in order to have it ready afterwards to plant. We have tested the same mechanism in Brazil in two places. It's now the third machine. The other ones in Brazil we used on the existing rotative hole of 120 width, which is definitely too wide for vegetable bed, or too wide too for bed to plant trees. And in a way, as we cultivate trees, we do produce organic matter in order to get to organize a double row or deposit a double row of organic matter upon the seed bed, normally 1 meter width, and so you have covered the whole soil. And at the same time, cutting afterwards the grasses and the herbs on the side, you don't have problems with a seed bed, which due to the fact that it's a little bit looser, it can come a little bit higher than the rest of your landscape. this is a typical subsoiler. You have here, well, first the form in order to facilitate to come in, and then this part here, it helps, or it only lifts the soil, it breaks the soil and lifts the soil. This one is half, is only half, and this has a counterpart on the front in order to cut the grass, divide the grass stalks on the side. In modern tree planting operation, we use a ripper. And the ripper just opens a fend in the soil and brings the earth to the side. If you do it when it's very dry, it breaks a little bit off, but it doesn't lift sufficiently. So often you have it pressed to the side and it opens it. But you have a lot of clumps of earth which is difficult afterwards to plant. Whereas this one, it lifts the soil, as you say, it breaks off, lifts it. Instead of bringing it to the side, it lifts it, and you see, if you look on the side, in this machine, it's exactly the underneath the rotative hole where this V, which lift the soil, and so what is being lifted, it breaks down, and so you have a completely smooth surface and all the whole bed without mixing different layers, it's all prepared. And then with the existing machine, there's another problem. You lift, or you pass, you open, and often, which is very, very common, instead of planting in a prepared soil, it's in clumpy, in a clumpy situation, and then it has a lot of, your plant has a lot of difficulty to create its root system. We tested it in summertime first, in beginning August, in an extreme dry situation. At that time, corn, which had been planted nearby, was merged, as I said, nearly dry leaves, and in a very heavy soil, we passed once, and the seed bed was perfect. 60 centimeters, 55 centimeters, all broken, and on the top, the rootstocks of the grasses, all cut.
So the machine is fixed on the tractor with the standard 3-point. So you can fix this machine on nearly every tractor. Need nothing special. Then the rotativa is driven by the shaft. Now we work with 540 rotations per minute. It's also possible to drive it with 1000 rotations. Then, yeah, there are two parts of the machine. One is the rotativa, we saw. It's built like a standard machine. We got the gearbox here and a chain outside, which drives the shaft from the rotativa. It's like a standard machine, it's just 80 centimeters, what it makes special. On behind, we have these three rippers. And how Ernest said, the position of the rippers is special, that the rippers are under the rotativa. You got standard machines, they have the rippers sometimes before the rotativa, but a long way before, or behind. And in this case, where they are under the rotativa, they can work together with the rotativa. So they lift the soil, and the soil is cutted up there. Then we have different possibilities to adjust. For one possibility is the highness of the whole machine. So with these screws, we have four positions for these plates. And these plates gives the deepness we go into the ground. So these plates slide on the grass and give us the deepness we work. The other possibility is the highness of the ripper, also for position, so we can adjust how deep the whipper goes into the ground.
Okay, now you can test it.
Okay.
Você tem um centro? Você tem um centro? Você tem um centro? Depois, você tem um lateral? Ok, tá perfeito. Qualquer árvore que você planta. So you have this shape of seed bed. So all water you have, it goes to the plant. Then you give organic matter upon, and so it's completely protected. Here again to the bottom. The advantage we have with this implement or this machine is that we need only a quarter, 25% maximum of the energy to do it. And we need half of the time. And the result afterwards is better. The quality is much better.
Now I like to show you how we can disconnect the machine from the tractor. Because the problem is, we have the rippers here, and if we let go the machine down on the ground, it will fall back. So we first can put the ripper from the driving position into the parking position. So this is now the feet of the machine in the back. We can do the same here. Just open it, slide it out. And fix it. Down. Oh, yes. Like he's doing on the other side. Now we can put the machine down on the earth. Now we are ready to disconnect the machine. The machine is designed and developed to according all of the safety restrictions we have to use in agriculture at this year. We have the CE certification and it's safe to use how it has to be.
Technology is marvelous. It's one of the modern features of man I admire, which could be in all sense positive.